हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी न्यूमेरिकल फ्रॉम यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर। सो द क्वेश्चन गिवन हियर इज फाइंड द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ गैस ए इन द बल्ब। फाइंड द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर। सो वी नो दैट एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर प्लस गेज प्रेशर, करेक्ट। सो आई राइट हियर पी एब्सोल्यूट इक्वल टू पी एटमोस्फेरिक प्लस पी गेज। पी गेज क्वेश्चन इज वेरी सिंपल, फाइंड द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ गैस ए इन द बल्ब। सो ए पॉइंट इज हियर एंड पी ए इज मेंशनड हियर, सो वी हैव टू फाइंड द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ गैस ए इन द बल्ब। इफ यू लुक इन टू द डायग्राम आई कैन सी हियर A is a point here, A point, then B, B is this side, C point and D point, correct. And the density of the liquid is given as 13.6 gram per milliliter. You have to convert this unit into kg per meter cube. 13.6 gram, right? So gram I have to convert into kg. So 10 to the power minus 3 kg. Right, kg per milliliter, correct. So we know that 1 milliliter equal to 10 to the minus 3 liter, correct. So I'll write here 10 to the minus 3 liter, and we also know that 1 meter cube equal to 1000 liter. So 1 liter equal to 1 by 1000 at 10 to the minus 3 meter cube. So 1 liter again you have to multiply, so this you will get it 13.6 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 10 to the power minus 6, correct. So on the numerator we are having kg, here you will get meter cube. Please calculate. So after calculation 13.6 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 10 to the power of minus 6 equal to, I am getting 13,600, right? 13,600 kg per meter cube, which is the density of the mercury, right? Hg. It is not mentioned, but density is given. So we have to find like this. Density of mercury is 13,600 kg per meter cube. Now the question is, we have to find the absolute pressure, and we have written the formula for absolute pressure: atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. So what we'll do, we'll start from here. So you can see this is open to atmosphere. So till this point it is atmospheric pressure PATM. Till this point it is atmospheric pressure PATM. So at A it's already atmospheric pressure, but if you go below A we are having the liquid, correct. This liquid is water. You can see here water is given here. So if you are going down, I told you if you are going down it is positive, going down is positive and going up is negative. Like this we keep on calculating the pressure. So you can see on this side, left side I am writing the equation, final equation. One line is sufficient. So P absolute equal to P atmospheric plus P gauge. I'll write the same equation again. P absolute equal to P atmospheric plus P gauge. Okay. What is absolute pressure formula or value? 101325 Newton per meter square, right? In Pascal, I will write here. So now I'm at this point A. Now from A, I'm going down. From A, I'm going down. So going down is positive. So what is the height given here? 5 centimeter, right? This liquid is up to 5 centimeter. So rho GH. So rho is water, it is. So 1000 rho G into H. What is H here? H is height, 5 centimeter. Convert into meter, you are getting 0.05 meter. So we reach to point F now. From F to E, again we have to calculate, again we have to go down. So plus rho GH. Now it is a dark liquid, you can see mercury, 13,600 kg per meter cube into G, 9.81 rho G into H. What is H value? 2 centimeter. Convert into meter, 0.02. Correct. Now we reach to this point E. Correct. E point. E and D are on the same level. Can you see E and D are on the same level? So the pressure will be same. So we can directly jump from E to D in this side, and then we'll go up. So now we reach to D point. Correct. So we are taking exactly a U-turn like this. We just keep on calculating and taking a U-turn like this. Okay. So everywhere we are calculating the pressure. And if below this pressure or below this level of liquid, below this level or reference line, if same liquid is present, then you can take a germ. That means liquid at these two points will be having the same pressure. So from E to D we reached, and after that we are going to see the pressure at point A. That means we have to directly go to point A, because same liquid is present, water. From D to C, water is present directly, so we can calculate. But this time we are going in the upward direction, so negative minus sign rho 1000 into G 9.81 into H. So 10 plus 5 plus 2 is 17. 17 centimeter converted to meter 0.17. Right. So this is the full equation. I'm closing here. So if you calculate this, if you calculate this, you will be getting as 1028.16.12 Newton per meter square. This unit we are getting because we are writing the Newton per meter square. Look at this PATM value. So if you want to write down in mm, so we know this relation 1 mm equal to, I'll write in the top here, 1 mm of Hg is equal to 133. Correct. We have seen this 133 per Newton per meter square. Correct. So in 1 mm of Hg, 133.3 Newton per meter square. So if you have to convert this Newton per meter square into mm of Hg, you just divide by 133.3. Okay. You just divide by 133.3. Then you'll get the mm of Hg. If you divide this, you will be getting as 771.3137 mm of mercury. Right. So this is the final answer, which is matching with the option A. Option A. Okay. So here is the right answer. Thank you.